Hello everyone, welcome back to Bandits Tarot by Cerithic Pathways. My name is Isaac, thank you for joining me in the video, okay? So, we will be discussing the three major astrological components of your natal chart, and that consists of your sun sign, your rising sign, and your moon sign. We will be covering all of those in this video. So, I'll be giving you an explanation of all three and why they play a very significant role within your personality. Before we go any further, I'm going to ask that you give the video a thumbs up. Slap that subscribe button. It really helps out my channel. It really doesn't cost anything, but it lets YouTube know that the content is indeed being watched and viewers like you are engaged. So, again, give it a thumbs up. It helps with the algorithm. Anyways, let's go ahead and hop into this video. The first thing that I want to discuss is the sun sign. The sun sign. Whenever someone asks you for your sun sign, it's most likely the sign that you associate it with the best. It's a sign that you identify with through horoscopes or through memes on the internet. Trivial astrology posts, for example, have a lot of sun sign astrology. For example, you may see a meme that says that Geminis are talkative and they're social butterflies. That's a sun sign quality for sun in Gemini people. However, there's more to that personality than just the sun sign. You also have the moon sign, you also have the rising sign, along with other planetary placements within that person's natal chart. But the sun sign is associated with what we identify with, the aspects and the traits that we are brought into this lifetime with that we do subconsciously. We really don't try. We don't really attempt to be our sun sign. We just are our sun sign. Like, I'm sun in Leo, for example. People don't go around walking trying to be their sun sign. It's just something that comes to you naturally. Now, with that being said, this video is not going to downplay the meaning of the sun sign, because the sun sign definitely does play a significant role within your natal chart. Sometimes it's the most influential planet, okay? Especially if you are a Leo rising and Leo's ruled by the sun. You see how that can play a big part in forming and shaping one's personality. So, now that we discussed the sun sign a little bit, let's go ahead and hop into the moon sign. Now, the moon sign is something that people may not be as familiar with when it comes to the sun sign. When someone typically comes up to you and they ask for your sign, they're asking for your sun sign. And some people out there may read a lot of astrology posts on the internet or read astrology posts on the internet and on the newspaper and stuff. And be like, well, I'm not really associating with this. And that comes the same people that says, oh, well, horoscopes and astrology are bullshit. Those people are most likely not going by their moon sign. Your moon sign is your emotional environment. It's your inner world. It's how we emotionally react to the situations that we are placed in. Okay? The moon sign represents the relationship with our mother. It can also reveal childhood events and trauma as well. So whenever we're talking about the moon sign, this is not something that you're going to immediately see from a person. The moon sign really comes out to people that know that person personally in real life behind closed doors. So if you are trying to find out someone's moon sign, then you're really not going to see that until you get to know them on a more personal level. The moon is a very personal planet. I'm one of those people that do argue it is one of the most personal planets in our natal chart. Like I said, it's how we emotionally react to our environment. So let's say, for example, that the moon is in a water sign and let's say Scorpio. The moon's in Scorpio. The moon is debilitated in Scorpio, which means it doesn't like to be in that particular sign. So, a moon in Scorpio person, when put in a very stressful environment or situation, may lash out anger. That's why moon in Scorpio gets a bad rap. Emotional outbursts, very passionate about what they feel about things. But again, shout out to Moon and Scorpio if you are a Moon and Scorpio. Nothing against y'all, I was just using you for an example. But yeah, it's how we emotionally react. It really governs our inner world. It's the safe haven that we can always come back to at the end of the day and identify with is our moon sign. So let's go ahead and move on to the rising sign. The rising sign is something that is tricky. It's almost confused with the MC, but we're not going to go that far into it. The rising sign is basically the face and the persona that we give off to people that we don't know. So for example, if you're just walking in the grocery store and it's kind of like, it's not like everyone goes around guessing someone's signs, but that does happen. Someone may see you across the room and say, I bet he's a Gemini, or I bet she's a Pisces. Like, just an automatic assumption of the sign that you are is the rising sign. It's not necessarily, that cannot necessarily be who you are, but that's how people look at you and perceive you. That's what you give off to other people is your rising sign. Again, I don't think that the rising sign is important though, because it does dictating what houses fall in which signs of your chart. And in order to know that information, you have to know your exact time of birth, because unlike the moon sign and the sun sign that changes, that cycles through each one of the 12 zodiacs within days, 48 hours, 36 hours, it fluctuates like the moon, and then the sun changes signs every month. The rising sign can change signs every hour. So that's why astrologists say that it's important to know your exact time of birth. That way we know, what sign the rising was in at that time. It really sets a platform for all your houses. So yeah, it is important, but it's not necessarily who you are as a person. It really doesn't define your personality. It's more of the astrological makeup of your chart, if that makes any sense. It's kind of like the meat and potatoes. Some people don't know their rising sign. A lot of people don't know their rising sign. But that's okay, because you don't need to know your exact time of birth in order to get a natal chart reading. As long as you know your birthday, we can work with that, despite who you go to. But it is better to have your rising sign, because it's going to be more accurate when it comes to the houses. So yeah, guys, hopefully that you got something from this video. That was a quick rundown of each one of the three astrological main components of your natal chart: your sun, your moon, your rising. If I missed something in this video, include it within the comments below. Also, comment below, tell me what sign you're in. Like, what's your moon sign? What's your rising sign? I'm curious to know. Until I see you, thank you for watching. Goodbye.